I'm here with Marcus from Invert Mouse. How are you going?
Hey, yeah, good. Thanks.
You've got two games here.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah,
Unhack and Bermuda.
That's right.
So, how long have you been developing the two games?
Mm-hmm. So for Unhack, I've been working on it for about 6 months now.
Yeah.
And as for Bermuda, it's actually been only going on for about 3 or 4 weeks.
Okay. I kind of figured that because it was a shorter demo.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Any chance of expanding upon Bermuda?
Yeah, absolutely. So, to be honest, the Bermuda demo actually kind of fails to show what the game is really about.
Yeah.
So Bermuda is actually a real-time survival adventure game where all the options, you know, all the choices that you make is going to have an effect on the different endings.
Gotcha.
That the game can.
Because it only showed off only one aspect of it, which was the hunting, I suppose it was.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah. As you saw in the trailer, there's also aspects like you have to cook the food, you have to go to bed, you have to shower, things of that sort. And as you're doing all that, you have to manage the time to also try and discover the mysteries behind the alien submarine that you're trapped in.
Yeah,
so all the games that I make are actually just excuses to tell stories. I'm mainly a storyteller first, and games.
You can't go wrong with that.
Yeah.
And what's the story behind Unhack?
The story behind Unhack is you're an unhacker fighting against computer viruses, and as the story develops, the AI companions that help you fight, they start and get more and more desperate to find out, you know, who's behind all these computer virus crimes, and they start making mistakes, and things go all wrong from there.
Oh, but, and what engine are you using for both games?
For both games, they're actually created in HTML5 using CreateJS.
Really?
Yeah, that's right.
Nice.
And that's why we had that little printing accident that we had just now.
Yeah, because everyone here is using Unity and Cocos.
Mm-hmm.
HTML5, I think it's the first HTML5 game I've played to this caliber.
Oh,
how long did it take to make that working as it is?
Yeah, well, as mentioned previously, it's about 5 to 6 months.
Yeah.
So earlier, I actually had my composer, Matt, who was supposed to rock up, but unfortunately we were all kicked out.
And I
think they're still coming back, so I did have some help, I don't want to say it's all me. So Matt was the one who composed the music, and I've also got Hybrid Mink to an online illustrator to help out with the character art.
Very, very nice.
Yeah.
So how's it been coding in HTML5?
Coding,
especially for gaming.
Yeah, I think it's actually pretty okay. So I actually use a script called CoffeeScript. It's a way where you can write JavaScript using a lot less lines and much simpler syntax, and then after that you can compile down to JavaScript. So I like it quite a lot. It lets me do a thing like what I call brainless coding, where I'm just kind of
and
then lines just come out. So it's actually not that bad.
So development platforms, PC or browser-based, I assume?
Yeah, browser-based, but I'm also able to convert these into executables for the PC, Mac, Linux, and also hopefully the iPad as well.
Nice.
Yeah, that's the advantage of using HTML5, because it runs in the browser, so by default your game is going to run on an iPad.
Yeah.
And it goes from
any
there.
Any distribution platforms you're thinking of? GOG, Humble Bundle, Steam,
Things like that.
Chrome
Store. Let's be honest now, Steam is extremely difficult to get onto, I think any of those other ones to begin with.
Yeah.
And go from there.
Right, Marcus, pleasure to talk to you, buddy.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Have a good day, and the game's looking great.
Yeah,
plays fantastic. I hope it all goes well for you, man.
Yeah,
seriously.
Thanks very much.